we have first radius of curvature as 10 cm, second radius of curvature as 20 cm. Fine. Refractive index of the material of the lens is given 1.5 and surrounding have refractive index of 1. We need to find focal length of this lens. So whenever you hear focal length and your radius of curvature is given, lens maker formula should immediately strike. So 1 by f should be equal to what? Mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by mu 1, 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2. Now object is this side, observer is that side. So the incident ray will come from here, isn't it? So mu 2 is what? 1.5, mu 1 is 1. This multiplied by, what is the r 1? Plus 10 or minus 10?
Plus 10.
Right? Because I am measuring in this direction radius of curvature and incident ray is also coming like that. Okay? So 1 by 10 minus r 2 is what? Plus 20 minus 15. Plus 20 only. So this is 20. Fine. So 1 by f you get as 1 by 2 into 1 by 20. So f comes out to be 40 centimeters. See, now we have almost every formula, whatever we had to learn from this chapter, we can mix and match. So we can have lens and mirrors together. We can have multiple lenses together. We can have multiple mirrors and a lens together. Fine. So write down this question. A point source S is placed 15 centimeter from converging lens of focal length 10 centimeter on its principal axis. Okay, so a point source is on its principal axis. Focal length 15 centimeter. Okay, where should a diverging mirror, where should you place a diverging mirror so that real image is formed on the source itself? Okay? Fine. Now, there are at times such scenarios where you will not be able to solve the question if you do not draw the ray diagram. So are you able to visualize what is happening right now? Exactly, are you able to see what is happening? You may not be able to do it, right? Just right now. But if you draw a ray diagram, it will give you, you know, a bridge for understanding more the situation, okay? And once you understand the situation properly, then only you can use the formula more effectively. Okay, so try to first draw the ray diagram and see what is happening. Have you drawn? Here we have a converging lens and a diverging mirror. Okay, what is the converging lens? What kind of lens it is?
Convex.
What? Okay, so we have a convex lens and a
convex
and convex mirror also. Fine. Convex mirror diverges, convex lens converges. Okay. So the situation is something like this. You have a convex lens and you have a mirror. Okay, and then you will have a source here. Fine. Can you draw a ray diagram for the situation?
It goes through, goes down and goes up.
It goes like this. What will happen to this ray?
It will come back.
So image will be on this line only, somewhere. Okay. Now this is another ray. What should happen to this ray?
Goes down.
It converges, right? So it goes something like this. Then what happens to this ray? What? If it goes up again like this, will this am saying the image will be on this line also, so the image gets formed here. Are you getting the point? Image should be formed here. So what should happen to this layer? If it goes down, the image will be somewhere here.
No. So like it goes down, it goes through the lens again.
What?
Like it has, it goes through the lens again. Yeah.
Okay, correct. So if it goes like this, then what will happen? It will converge. So it may converge like this.
You have to keep it a specific lens.
So yeah, exactly. So what I'm saying is, what is that specific position?
How it should happen? What's the focal length of the camera?
Focal length is 10 cm. So focal length for the lens is 10 cm and focal length for the diverging mirror
should be given, right?
12 cm. Focal length of this is 12 cm. You need to find this distance. Okay? This distance is given as 15 cm. What is this x? Okay? But what if it strikes the mirror along the normal? Suppose this is center of curvature. What will happen to this then? What will happen to this wave?
Huh?
It gets reflected back along the same line. So it retraces its path. And then image gets formed here or not? Okay? So the situation here should be that this ray of light hits the diverging mirror along the normal. Getting it? So the image due to this lens should be formed where? Should be formed at the radius of curvature of this mirror. Are you getting it? Now try to solve this question.
So will it happen at all? Sir, will it happen at all x values? No, right. Because for me it somehow cancels out.
Okay, what is radius of curvature if focal length is 12? 24, so this should be 24, right? So if this is 24, what is the distance of image for the lens? It will be x plus 24, isn't it? So we have the situation where u is what? Minus 15 cm, v is what? 24 plus x cm, and f is plus 10 cm. Right? So I will use the lens formula here. 1 by V minus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. So 1 by 24 plus X minus 1 by minus 15 is equal to 1 by 10. Fine?
So it's getting 5 cm.
You're getting X as 5?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so you get
6.
Yeah, 6.
Just check, you might have made some silly errors.
So why is the focus positive when you...
Exactly, that I wanted one of you to ask that question actually. So it has two focal points here and there. So why have you taken plus 10, why not minus 10? What is focal length? You assume a parallel ray of light and where they appear to converge or actually converge, distance of that point. So if a parallel ray come like this, where will converge? There. So when you have object here, focal point should be considered this side. Because if parallel ray come from this side, it will converge that side. Okay? Had it been